Hello and welcome once again to MBAbullshitDotCom. So our topic for this video is present value, right? So before anything else, I'd like to remind you that you can always go back to MBAbullshitDotCom for your fun and funny, easy tutorials. So it doesn't matter if you're a business or college student or MBA or an executive or a non-business moron like I was before. Alright? So now, let's get right down to it. Now, I'd like to start with a story. Let's say that your grandmother gave you money when you were younger, a certain amount of money, and you don't remember how much that money was, alright? But anyway, all you remember is that you put it in a bank for 7 years, and in the bank it earned 6% interest, alright? 6% interest rate. And after that 7 years, you have $100. Okay? Now the question is, how much do you think your grandmother gave you 7 years before today, or 7 years before it becomes $100? Alright, so in this problem, alright, this $100, which is the amount after 7 years, okay, this $100 is called future value. Alright, so in order, and the future value is written as FV in the formula, alright, and this money, the amount that your grandmother gave you before the 7 years, is called present value or past value. Alright? So it depends on how the story is told. If I'm telling the story saying that $100 is today, then the amount here is called past value. But if I'm telling the story saying that your grandmother gives this money to you today, and then in the future you get $100, then the money today is called present value. Alright? So I highly recommend using the word past value instead of present value, because the word present value can be confusing, because the word present can change depending, or the meaning of the word present can change depending on how the story is told. However, in business school, your professor will almost always call this present value, even when he is talking about the past. So don't be confused about it. Present value, past value, it's the same thing mathematically when you use math. Alright? So anyway, the question is, how do we compute the past value or the present value? Well, it's very simple. We compute it by using a formula, and in that formula we need all of these variables over here. We need the future value, which we write as FV. We need the past value or present value, which we write as PV. We have the interest rate, which we write as R, and we have the number of years, which we write as 7. And using these variables here, we make our formula over here. So this formula may look very scary and intimidating, but don't panic, because these things, all these crazy letters and numbers over here, just represent the stuff over here, down here, which we already know. And in order to find out the present value here, we simply use the formula here, because the PV over here is the same as the PV over here. Present value or past value. The FV over here talks about the future value, which is the amount after the 6% interest rate for 7 years. Alright? So, simple as that. Oh, and one more thing. This FV over here is just one variable, okay? So don't be confused. This is not two variables, F and V. No, it is just one variable, FV, which means future value, and that is $100. And it's the same for PV. This is one variable, PV. It is not P multiplied by V, as you might have learned in earlier math when you were a child or in high school during algebra. Alright? So, anyway, we move on now and see how we can use these variables and how we can plug these figures into this formula up here. Alright? It's quite simple. So, we already know from the previous slide that the future value is $100, which is what goes here. We know that N is 7, which is what goes here. We know that the interest rate R is 6%, which is what goes here. All right?